When people walk into our production lines for the first time, I think they're a little surprised that we actually don't have robots building robots. When you look at high volume production lines and manufacturing facilities that have high volume, you'll see a lot of that because they're not making changes a lot. They're producing hundreds or thousands of products a day. And we've built about 3,500 robots in 15 years that are actually out in production. And what we need to focus on is the mobility and the flexibility to make changes frequently and be able to deploy those. In an environment where you have robots building robots, you take away all that flexibility. You don't have the ability to make a change and implement it or integrate it into your process and then turn around and deploy it to the field. You have to go through major process changes and retooling and reprogramming of those products. By using humans, we actually can make those changes rapidly and we can do them very efficiently and implement a very timely deployment to our customer base. With that said, we are in a very highly regulated environment, and because of that high regulation, we need to simplify things as much as possible for our employees. And so automation, where possible, through our business systems and technology in terms of work instructions and training and our device history records and all those things, we automate those processes. But the physical build of the product and testing it and getting the feel of what it is, you can only get that through humans. You can't get that through robots. And so the things that make sense, the documentation, training records, quality records, all of those things are automated. But the physical turning of the screwdriver and tuning and tweaking and getting the robot to be as perfect as possible requires the touch of a human hand.